Volcanoes. They've reshaped continents, blacked out skies, and triggered some of the worst extinction events in Earth's history. In fact, they've played a role in 4 out of the 5 major mass extinctions. And yet, life doesn't just come back, it explodes back. And nothing shows this better than the rapid rise of dinosaurs, a group that dominated the planet for over 140 million years, but there was a time when dinosaurs were much lower down on the food chain. The real kings of the late Triassic were not dinosaurs at all. It was dominated by massive amphibians and giant crocodile relatives like Postosuchus, monsters stretching up to 7 meters, that's 23 feet long, and weighing nearly a ton. Meanwhile, the largest predatory dinosaurs were Hererosauridae, who are almost comically small compared to later Jurassic giants, with the largest coming in at only 5 meters, that's 16 feet long, and roughly 350 kilograms, that's 770 pounds. But this all changed 201 million years ago. The Earth experienced one of the most violent extinction events of its history, the Triassic-Jurassic extinction. Massive volcano eruptions released enormous amounts of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. This triggered a runaway greenhouse effect, raising global temperatures by over 10 degrees Fahrenheit and transforming Earth's climate. Oceans acidified, sea levels dropped, and ecosystems collapsed under the pressure, wiping out nearly 75% of all species. This essentially reset the food chain, and it didn't take evolution long to start working its magic, as only around 2 million years after the mass extinction, barely a blink in geological terms, one of Earth's first truly large predatory dinosaurs emerged. This was Dilophosaurus. Hollywood is known for exaggerating things for dramatic effect, especially when it comes to dinosaurs and other prehistoric animals. They dramatically and inaccurately increased the size and toughness of almost all extinct prehistoric creatures. However, there is one exception to this rule, and while the movies have altered its physical attributes greatly, it was actually more terrifying in real life than any movie portrayed. Movies show Dilophosaurus as a small, venom-spitting, frilled dinosaur, but the reality is, they were far more terrifying, and were one of the first kings and apex predators of the Jurassic, alongside being the largest creature in their ecosystem. They had no frills, and there was no evidence at all that they were able to spit venom. They were far less theatrical. But Dilophosaurus didn't need theatrics. Its size, speed, and agility were more than enough. Stretching around 7 meters, that's 23 feet in length, and weighing around 400 kilograms, comparable in weight to today's largest Siberian tigers. But what makes it even more impressive is that before the extinction event, the Hererosaurus family had existed for roughly 30 million years before the extinction, yet none surpassed around 350 kilograms. But within just 2 million years after the extinction event, Dilophosaurus was already significantly larger than any predatory dinosaurs from the Jurassic. With its slender but powerful build, large double-crested skull, and an array of sharp teeth, it quickly became a dominant predator. The ancestors of Dilophosaurus were smaller, basal theropods, little dinosaurs who are thought to have survived the Triassic-Jurassic extinction event. But with giant predators like the Postosuchus wiped out, these modest survivors adapted to the new environment, growing rapidly in size and filling the empty roles left behind by the vanished apex predators. And it seems evolution was not slowing down from there, it was only speeding up, as we only have to fast forward another 2 million years and another bigger and stronger apex predator was emerging in Antarctica. Today is known to be a frozen wasteland filled with mainly penguins and having no large land predator, unless you count a leopard seal as a land predator. Rewind 200 million years and Antarctica was very different. Instead, it was much warmer, filled with dense forests and a wide range of life, and plenty of land predators, with the largest being the Cryolophosaurus, whose name ironically means cold-crested lizard. Cryolophosaurus emerged around 5 million years after the extinction event, and had already grown to sizes of 7 meters, that's 23 feet long, and weighing roughly 500 kilograms, that's 1,100 pounds, with some estimates suggesting it potentially grew to 700 kilograms, that's 1,500 pounds. Even at the lower estimates, this puts it significantly larger than Dilophosaurus, which also means it only took evolution 5 million years after the extinction event to produce multiple predators in different areas on the planet, bigger than Postosuchus, which previously ruled for over 30 million years. But impressive size wasn't Cryolophosaurus' strangest feature. Perched upon its skull was an elaborate crest, unlike any other dinosaur before or since. A sideways, fan-shaped ornament reminiscent of Elvis Presley's famous hairstyle, and earning it the nickname Elvisaurus. This weird-looking crest was likely not useless either. It was probably used for display, species recognition, or attracting mates, a sign of an ecosystem rapidly becoming crowded enough to require dramatic ways for dinosaurs to distinguish themselves from competitors. But how did a dinosaur this large and specialized appear so quickly after an extinction event? Paleontologists believe it evolved from smaller surviving basal theropods, similar to those ancestral to Dilophosaurus. Among these survivors may have been dinosaurs like Pendrike, small, agile carnivores that weathered the catastrophic conditions of the extinction and once again quickly diversified to fill the roles left behind by massive extinct predators. Cryolophosaurus wasn't alone in this evolutionary sprint. In Asia, roughly around the same time, another apex predator was emerging, Cenosaurus. Comparable in size at around 6 meters, that's 20 feet long, and weighing approximately 500 kilograms, it featured powerful jaws lined with large serrated teeth. This parallel emergence of similar-sized apex predators on distant continents show how dramatically evolution was accelerating, producing formidable hunters in rapid succession across the globe. And these apex predators needed to grow rapidly in size, as it was not just the predators that seemed to be evolving fast, but the herbivores were arguably evolving even faster. Cryolophosaurus shared its environment with huge plant-eating dinosaurs like Glacialosaurus, a monster of its time. While it was not a true sauropod, it was part of the early sauropodomorph family, and while no truly accurate reconstruction of this animal's weight has been calculated, multiple peer-reviewed papers have suggested that it reached sizes of 20 to 25 feet long and weighed almost 4 to 6 tons. If this is true, this would put it as one of the biggest animals to walk the planet for that time, by a long way. At full size, Cryolophosaurus would have struggled taking down one of these behemoths, but utilizing its powerful jaws and serrated teeth, it likely preyed on the young or injured of this species. So in just a few million years, dinosaurs went from hardly being known to having the biggest predators and also biggest herbivores the planet has ever seen. Yet, even Cryolophosaurus and Cenosaurus would soon be overshadowed by even bigger, stronger predators, because evolution wasn't slowing down, it was just warming up. To see the next dramatic leap in size and power, we have to fast forward about 30 million years. This brings us around 166 million years ago. This is when we meet one of the most infamous carnivores of the Jurassic, Megalosaurus. First discovered in the early 1800s in Oxfordshire, England, Megalosaurus wasn't just another apex predator, it was a milestone. When its bones were first discovered, we didn't even know dinosaurs existed yet. People thought these fossils belonged to elephants, or even giants. But in 1824, William Buckland gave it a name that would go down in history. Megalosaurus bucklandi, the first ever dinosaur formally described. Reaching lengths of around 9 meters, that's 30 feet, and tipping the scales an estimated 1 to 1.5 tons, it marked a significant jump in size and strength, dwarfing many earlier Jurassic predators. But it wasn't size alone that set Megalosaurus apart. Its robust build, powerful hind limbs, and heavily muscled jaws filled with serrated teeth revealed a predator equipped for tackling formidable prey. This was a hunter capable of taking down large herbivores, including early armored ornithischians as well as the increasingly massive sauropods roaming the Jurassic. The evolutionary arms race was beginning to ramp up even faster during this time. prey were growing tougher and larger, and predators like Megalosaurus were evolving to meet the challenge, Megalosaurus shared its environment with a diverse range of dinosaurs and other creatures. It coexisted with early sauropods like Satyrosaurus, smaller herbivorous ornithischians like Skeletosaurus, and possibly other early theropods. Other carnivorous competitors were present too, like the Eostreptus pondylus and Protoceratosaurus, which is thought to be an early relative of tyrannosaurs, though none quite matched the Megalosaurus in sheer size and power, placing it firmly at the top of the food chain. The rise of Megalosaurus shows how dinosaur evolution continued to accelerate after the initial post-extinction burst. Each new apex predator pushed the limits of size, strength, and hunting strategy. Dinosaur evolution is now heading into uncharted territory. No other group of animals had ever reached this scale, each generation growing larger, more specialized, and more dominant. Megalosaurus was clearly a trendsetter when it came to this, as from this point onwards, huge dinosaurs seemed to be popping up all around the globe, and less than 3 million years later, one of the most infamous dinosaurs of all time emerged, the Allosaurus. Appearing around 163 million years ago, Allosaurus was a true giant among theropods, growing up to almost 10 meters, that's 32 feet long, and weighing as much as 2.5 tons, it dwarfed Megalosaurus. This was a predator almost all dinosaur fans have heard of, with massive jaws lined with 32 sharp serrated teeth, powerful hind limbs, and strong arms tipped with three-fingered claws designed for grasping and slashing prey. Allosaurus ruled vast ecosystems across what is now North America and parts of Europe during the late Jurassic. It hunted this era's largest herbivores, including massive sauropods like Diplodocus and Camarasaurus, as well as armored dinosaurs like Stegosaurus. And speaking of Stegosaurus, this is also when herbivores started fighting back with some serious firepower. For the first time in the fossil record, we have direct evidence of a plant eater killing a top predator. One fossil shows a deep puncture wound in the pelvic bone of an Allosaurus, left by none other than a Stegosaurus tail spike. The injury was brutal, and it's almost certain the Allosaurus died from its injuries. That's not just a lucky shot, that's a defensive weapon doing its job. This encounter is so famous and well known, we already have a video on Buried Earth of Stegosaurus thagomizers. The evolutionary arms race between predator and prey was intensifying, with herbivores growing bigger and better defended, and predators evolving new strategies and physical adaptations to overcome them. This time period was teeming with giant theropods competing for dominance. Species like Torvosaurus, one of the largest known Jurassic predators, rivaling Allosaurus in size, and Ceratosaurus, recognizable by its distinctive nasal horn. All of them coexisted in the same ecosystems, locked in a brutal game of survival and dominance. We've talked a lot about predators and their explosive growth after the Triassic-Jurassic extinction, but there's one group of dinosaurs that saw an even more dramatic surge, more so than any other, and that is the sauropods, the iconic long-necked giants. Before this extinction event, the giants of the herbivore world were not the massive, lumbering sauropods we imagine today. Instead, the landscape was dominated by smaller, more modestly sized relatives called basal sauropodomorphs or prosauropods, which were mostly bipedal or semi-bipedal and nowhere near the scale of their future Jurassic descendants. But after the extinction event cleared the way, true sauropods evolved rapidly and explosively. The earliest of these giants, like Volcanodon, emerged shortly after the extinction, roughly 200 million years ago, only 1 million years after the extinction event. Measuring around 10 meters, that's 33 feet long, and weighing 3 to 5 tons, Volcanodon showcased the beginnings of the sauropod body plan. Long necks, massive limbs, and a fully quadrupedal stance. Only a few million years later, even larger sauropods like Baroposaurus appeared, at 15 to 18 meters, that's 50 to 60 feet long, and tipping the scales an estimated 7 tons, Baroposaurus was a giant of its time, able to reach high into the treetops and dominate its environment. It shows how quickly herbivores were evolving during this time, but this was just the beginning. Fast forward to the late Jurassic, around 150 million years ago, and sauropods were reaching truly colossal sizes. Enter Supersaurus, one of the longest dinosaurs ever discovered, measuring at ridiculous lengths, between 33 and 40 meters, that's 108 to 131 feet. But its weight estimates vary greatly though, but many research papers and journals hover around between 38 and 44 tons, that's 35,000 to 40,000 kilograms. Just in 50 million years, the sauropods went from primitive creatures to some of the biggest animals the planet has ever seen. These titans reshaped entire ecosystems with their sheer bulk and feeding habits, consuming vast amounts of vegetation and forcing predators to adapt accordingly. The rapid increase in sauropod size after the Triassic-Jurassic extinction highlights just how quickly evolution can rocket forward when the right conditions arise. The Triassic-Jurassic extinction hit reset on life, and evolution hit fast forward. Dinosaurs didn't just survive, they exploded onto the scene. From nimble hunters like Dilophosaurus to giants like Allosaurus and the towering sauropods, they rose fast and took over. It's proof that after disaster, life doesn't just bounce back, it transforms. We've mentioned many milestones and dinosaurs in today's video, but let us know in the comments section what are some of your favourite dinosaurs from the Jurassic and any milestones you think might be important that we missed. My name's Joe, thank you so much for watching.